Hello everyone, this is Trilok Singh Mish with Economics BBC once again in 2019. You have seen a lot of my videos last year. It was for the benefit of all the students who are preparing for CBSE board exam. So today I am coming for you with the macroeconomics. I want to give you a little brief of macroeconomics, what macroeconomics is all about and how it was originated and what are we looking for into the macroeconomics. See, macroeconomics refers to the study of economy as a whole and it was introduced by J.M. Keynes in 1936. But before that I want to tell you, it was 1914 to 1918, there was a problem all over the world. What was the problem? That was a First World War. First World War was there, and as a First World War, what happened? The impact was that all the entrepreneurs shifted their resources to the arms elimination and the consumer goods production was reduced. And was reduced very, reduced to a good extent altogether, and everybody was producing the arms elimination because it was fetching them more profit. But in 1918, World War got over, and in 1918 we had a worldwide plague. That also took a lot of death toll over the world. As a result, what happened? When this was over, World War was over, what happened? Demand for all these arms eliminations is reduced, whereas there was a lot of stock of arms eliminations with the, most of the companies and all the units, corporate houses, and as a result, what happened? They didn't have the money to transfer this resources into some consumer goods. As a result, what happened? There was a lot of stock into the godowns of arms elimination was in the godowns, but consumer goods were not being produced. As a result, what happened? There was no income. No income, or less income you can say. Or less income. Income had reduced. When income is less and there's, you know, income is less and there's less commodities, what happened? Due to this, there was no demand also because people didn't have the money to buy the goods. Demand had gone down. As a result, what happened? There was a depression all over the world. Depression, what is depression? Depression is a sharp fall in the prices and widespread unemployment all over the world. As a result, what happened? This Great Depression from 1918 to 1930. In 1930, it was termed as the Great Depression of the world. I hope I am making myself very clear. I am just giving you things which are not in the book, which is a little common sense altogether, you know. Great Depression of the world. All over the world we were facing a Great Depression. Great Depression, depression is a situation which is characterized by large depression, let's say sharp fall in the price and widespread unemployment. And this is, we were not able to find a solution to it. We didn't have the solution, how to get this unemployment over, how to get over this unemployment and how to make the prices go up. Prices were going down and still there was no demand because there was unemployment. Ek taraf, there was no prices going down, dusri taraf berozgari badh rahi thi. As a result, what happened? There was no demand. There was a great depression all over the world. People were not able to sell anything, they were not able to purchase. People were facing a lot of problems. So in 1929, you can say, Lord John Maynard Keynes. Looking for a solution to this Great Depression. When J.M. Keynes started working on this, he took almost 7 years. In 1936, he came up with a solution through the book called The General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. General Theory of employment, interest, and money. With this combination, we came up with a solution. And what was the solution? I'll just tell you all. We just look at it earlier. The classical economist Adam Smith and his followers. They used to feel more saving. If you're saving more, what do you do? More savings means when you have more saving, what do you do? More saving means more income in future. More income means more consumption, more production. More production. This is more saving means more investment. You can invest more. More investment means more production. More production means more income again. And more income means more saving again. This was the classical vision, classical view. Classical economics used to be, if you save more, you'll be able to invest more. If you have invested more, you'll be able to produce more. If you produce more, you'll be able to generate more employment. If you're generating more employment, then you'll be able to create more income. If more income is there, you'll be able to save again more. Whereas, the Keynesian paradox, Keynes came with a different opinion. We call it Keynesian paradox. See, what did Keynes say? You'll have to listen to it carefully. He said, when you have more saving, if you're saving more, what are you doing? More saving leads to less consumption, means you are not eating much, you are consuming less. When your consumption is less, production will also be less, people will not produce when you are not demanding. Less production. When you are producing less, you will have less employment, you will not employ more people. Less employment. And when you have less employment, you will have less income, and when you have less income, you will lead to less saving in the future. In future, what does it say? You can see here, you're saying if you save more, you will be able to earn more and you will be able to save more. Whereas Keynes came with this solution that when we have more saving, it means we are spending less. If you're spending less, means your consumption is less. When consumption is less, children, we have less production. Why do we produce if nobody is demanding? If production is less, we'll have less employment also. We'll not employ more people. If the employment is less, people will not get much of income. When less income is there, although less income, they will definitely save less in the future. Whereas the classical economists say, when we save more, we ultimately save more in the future also. Whereas he said, when we are saving more, we are ultimately saving less in the future. Therefore, he came with a macroeconomic concept where he said, we need to spend more. The Keynesian paradox says that we need to spend more. The more investment we do, better it is for the economy, because it's talking about everyone. Because till the time we do not spend in the economy, the money, the income is not. So this is about the Keynesian paradox. This is your classical economics view, and this is how, this is the history of how macroeconomics came into existence. You need to remember the general theory of employment, interest and money, which was a publication which was published in 1936 after 7 years of rigorous work done by Lord John Maynard Keynes together with his followers, with his people. And this is how we end up, I wanted to make it very brief, up to the point so that everybody what is macroeconomics and why there is a need to study macroeconomics. With this, I'll come back again tomorrow to you with the further topics on macroeconomics. Tomorrow we'll talk about the inflationary gap and deflationary gap, and how can we correct the inflationary gaps, which results into deficient demand and efficient demand or excess demand in the economy. So till then, bye bye, take care, wish you all the luck for your board exams. Thank you.